So it's very important for us to push the limits and boundaries of what we do currently to take care of our patients. And new technologies are very important to be able to do that. I'm so happy that the National Institutes of Health, which is the biggest federal agency that funds this research, is funding this research too. And collaboration has really moved things forward. The complicated issues can be solved much easier. Our lab focuses on using imaging technology that we'd never know the concentration of drugs at the site of infections. We thought this would be a good idea.
And as a pediatric critical care physician, I'm very interested in brain inflammation and drugs being able to get to the brain. And so I think that's how we came up with this idea of looking at it in an infectious model in rabbits, and then also having patients that we were able to then compare and see if this model could be used to further look at different drugs. And so that was something that was really great, was being able to look at both patient and preclinical data and see how they interact and how it could be used in the future, and look at it in children, which are underrepresented in research overall.
Yeah, and I think we really did a good job of trying to integrate all the preclinical information with clinical information that was not only from the single patient but also from the literature. And the recommendations based on our results clearly tell us that for a drug that has been underdosed for over the last 50 years, we are recommending a dose of 30 milligram per kilogram or greater for in pediatric TBM.
So the importance of this is that we can use non-invasive imaging to be able to find what's happening inside each one of those sites of the body, to find out if the drug is actually reaching where it's supposed to reach, if we're underdosing, and we can apply this technology to multiple different drugs and multiple different diseases. It's was really useful, this collaboration between Johns Hopkins and the University of Maryland, to understand those results then with all the analysis that you could extrapolate then to patients. So this is something that it comes really useful in this era of precision medicine, where we need to understand how each patient behaves differently, why treatments in some patients work and some don't work, and we can't just keep on giving the exact same dose to everyone regardless of their specific conditions.
This comes back to the concept of precision medicine, which means we tailor treatments for each patient, and trying to develop tools that can actually help us in a rational way be able to give appropriate treatments to a single patient would be fantastic, and we hope that this could happen in the next few years.